Jordan's mantra. I walk into the gym in the morning at 5 o'clock in the morning, and not only is this guy already there and working out, but he's on his Bluetooth talking to Japan, Nissan Motors, about their trends from the previous day. This guy is, you look at his email, the bottom of his email says 24/7, then in parentheses, really. And he means, he talks to people 24/7, all about customer service. Jordan started, in 1984, Zimmerman Advertising in a small office in Fort Lauderdale while all the fat cats were up on Madison Avenue, and turned his business into a $3 billion advertising agency that's the 14th ranked advertising agency in the country. University of South Florida grad, he's on the board of trustees for the University of South Florida, equity owner in the Florida Panthers hockey team, and uniquely enough, has also got special permission from the NHL where he can actually have part of ownership in the Tampa Bay hockey team. So very unique in that sense. Very philanthropic, okay? He has multiple organizations that he's raised money for, on top of the fact that he's on the board of trustees of the University of South Florida. Very well known for an organization down here, a lot of you guys in South Florida based would know, called Z-Motion. Z-Motion is a cycling team with over 1,000 members that has raised more than $4 million for local charities. So very, very energetic, very active individual. 2013 FAU Business Leader of the Year. Previous winners, Jeb Bush, Mark Templeton from Citrix. I mean, these are the kind of people that have got these awards in the past. 2012 Ernst & Young Entrepreneur of the Year. So this is the kind of people that we want to get be involved with. And Chris knew of Jordan when I mentioned his name, but Jordan was kind enough to get us on his calendar, and I couldn't thank him enough. He's not only a good business leader, but a good friend of mine. So you guys, give me a warm welcome to Mr. Jordan Zimmerman.
Let me get everybody to come on in and before I start, so nobody misses anything. Mike, thank you for that great introduction. Mike, it was nice to meet you. And Chris, thank you very much as well. It's an honor to be here and speak to you and your company. I've known Mike for many years at the gym, as he said, and I just met Chris, and Chris and I had lunch. And it was very funny because it was like I was speaking to myself. You know? He's got an incredible drive, and I'm sure it's infectious within your organization. You know, it's like the answer is yes, now what's the question? I'm sure you're all familiar with that. I want to go back because I think, you know, what we start out as youngsters doing, for some reason we lose along the way, and that's dreaming. How do we forget that it's healthy to dream, that it's healthy to have huge goals, that it's healthy to say anything is possible, that it's healthy to think we need to differentiate ourselves, yes, ourselves, and our companies. How do we lose that? I don't know. But today, I think you're about to see how I recreated that and how I think it's going to be inspirational for each and every one of you. The first thing I want to say, and you can hear me say it throughout my presentation today, my chat with you, it's not about me. It's not about Zimmerman, the company I built. It's about all the clients that we represent. And you'll hear that over and over today. Every client we represent, we're only successful because they're successful. And we're tied into every one of their bottom lines. So the more successful they become, we have skin in the game. The more successful we become. They don't become successful, we left skin in the game, so we're not as successful. Now, how did I start? You know, I grew up in a little town in New Jersey, like Mike Murph, and I didn't grow up with any money. And I grew up like many of you, looking at all the people around me and saying, why are all my parents' friends miserable and hate what they do? Sound familiar? And why are all of my friends' parents miserable and hate what they do? I said, something's wrong here. So I realized early on, you had to have a goal, a dream. You had to know who you wanted to become. and you had to find the business you were passionate about, and you hopped out of bed every day and said, I can't wait to go to work. You had to find something you could differentiate in and be inspirational. But I realized you had to start at the bottom. So this was my first office. 400 square feet. And I was trying to figure out, with the $10,000 I had saved working in college and in graduate school, how I was going to afford to pay the rent. I had it stocked with used furniture and used equipment, and it was in the early 80s, right in the beginning of the technology revolution. So this is how it started. I lived in a back room of my parents' home on a sleeper sofa for 6 years. Now I ask you all today, it's all about sacrifice, and how many of you have sacrificed or will sacrifice for the greatness of your careers? To me, there was nothing more important than following my dream. And I was prepared to spend as much time and sacrifice as much as I had to get that career off and running. That was almost 30 years ago. And that 400 square foot office, we are opening up a new corporate center in this January, the 16th or the 19th, I'm not sure yet, and this is what it's going to look like. It's 130,000 square feet. We'll house over 1,000 employees just in our Fort Lauderdale headquarters, and we have 22 other offices throughout the United States. Now, if you ask this little kid from New Jersey if this was possible, I would have told you when I was a kid, absolutely anything is possible. So I ask you all today, as I start to give you some of the things I've learned along the way, they're all yours. Adopt them, understand them, embrace them. Now, as I move on, I say we are today the 14th largest agency, but probably this year will be 11th or 12th in the United States and probably the world. Now, I would have never imagined that as a kid, that I could actually build something that big. So I ask you all, somebody, when Mike, and Chris retire, slow down, as the previous owner did, somebody needs to step in. Does anybody have a vision of that? Does anybody have a goal of that? Does anybody understand the sacrifices that Chris, Mike, and Mike have made to get where they're at? And some of you are making those sacrifices now. But I'm going to tell you that the deeper you dig, the more opportunity you're going to have. Now, everyone said, no, wait, the world is falling apart, right? What are we going to do? Business comes to a screeching halt. It looks like all of our banks are about to go out of business. And I said to my team, this is an opportunity. And they look at you like you're nuts. And I said, of course you look at me like I'm nuts. You got, everyone has my entire career. Now I ask you all, you can hear me say, talk about insanity today. Do you want to be normal? Or do you want to be a little bit different and have an insane, infectious behavior that people start to rally around? That was really what my goal was. So in 08, I said, we are now going to dominate the advertising and marketing world. Just like your company has had fantastic growth during those years as well. Because leadership said, there is an opportunity here in the solutions business. There's an opportunity here in the cloud business. And we're going to dominate those businesses. But today, we're going to move that to a whole new level. We're going to move that into a service mode you never dreamed was possible. Mike talked about 24/7. I sleep, and my executive team, if you want to be a member of it, sleep with their cell phones next to their head. When your clients need you, you need to be there. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. When your client has an issue, a problem, Don't be part of the problem, be part of the solution. I say that all the time. But I want to go back to growth. If you look at our growth in 08, we were about a $2.4 billion company. And look what happened through 13. We became over a $3 billion company when everyone else in our industry was going this way. And these are some of the great brands that we represent. Now, man, you guys represent some incredible brands as well. In fact, when I had lunch with Chris that day, Mike Burke was supposed to be there, but he couldn't be there because he went to Atlanta to do what he had to do at securing and making sure that business stayed whole. Because that's what we do at the top level of the company, and that's what each and every one of you, if you're not doing it, needs to do it. Now, I speak a lot about output versus outcome. I want to relate it to my industry, then I'll relate it to yours. In my industry, there's plenty of agencies out there that focus on the output of the work. So their strategy starts in a very creative level. That's bullshit. It's all about the outcome of the work. It's about the outcome of the solution. There's plenty of companies that provide solutions, but do they truly integrate into the brand and understand what the challenges are that company has to provide them the best solution, to be the best partner you possibly can? That's what we do on that side. Our one goal is to make our clients' businesses grow. So when I talk about outcome versus output, we are an outcome-driven agency. It's all about the results. So our strategy starts not on a creative platform, based on how do we differentiate that brand, like Nissan. How do we make Nissan more important to all of you than Toyota or Honda?